Me? You got me?
MeTV is memorable entertainment television.
Sure sounds good.
With a lineup of classic television shows you remember.
I remember years later.
And shows you can discover for the very first time.
A lot of good stuff.
You can watch MeTV Fresno on Xfinity 375 starting August 25th.
Are you going to watch me or ain't you?
MeTV is memorable entertainment television.
Hello, I'm John Walsh. The Justice Network is seen here in Fresno and made possible by the Ventura Broadcasting Company. To see how law enforcement all across Central California are fighting crime, watch Local Choice with Austin Reed,
hey,
where you'll see interviews and special reports with those who keep us safe every day. Local Choice with Austin Reed, daily on the Justice Network, Fresno, exclusively on KVBC Channel 13.5.
When you like Ventura TV Appliance on Facebook, it's nice. But when you love the Whirlpool appliances we deliver, it's even better. Our website is cool, and it's a good place to start. But you really should touch the merchandise before you buy. Touch the new Whirlpool Ice Collection. It offers a modern style made to create an inspiring kitchen experience. Save big on this Whirlpool Black Ice or White Ice Kitchen. Come in to Ventura TV Appliance and touch the merchandise today.
Have you or a loved one recently been arrested for a serious crime?
Is your professional reputation at risk?
Aggressive representation from a qualified defense attorney can help you avoid conviction and keep your reputation untarnished.
Hi, I'm Charles McGill, and I'll fight for your rights. With extensive experience in successfully defending against a wide range of criminal offenses and high-profile cases, you can rest assured that you'll get the fair trial you deserve from McGill Guzman McGill. Call us at 559-255-3425 or visit us online at toplawyersfresno.com.
Hi, I'm John Mattles. Welcome to this live edition of Connect With Me on the showroom floor at Ventura TV on this day. Glad you're here on a Thursday morning. We're going to the movies, a movie that debuts right here in the city of Fresno. It's the red carpet debut. It's a film you won't want to miss. You can call in 436-ME-TV, option 11. Back in a moment. Back here on the program today, it's Arts and Culture Day. There's no question about that. And as a reminder, I'm going to remind you that today is October the 1st, 2015, and October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. That's why this is on my lapel. As a reminder to all of you, do the buddy check, not only all this month, but throughout the entire year, right? It's almost 2016, my friends, and I'm getting excited about the presidential run, but we won't talk about that today. We'll talk about some different things. Hey, tomorrow, a reminder that Joe Gomez will be here. He's the lieutenant from the Fresno Police Department. He's a spokesman. And there's been a rash of shootings, police officer-involved shootings, about four in the last month here in the city of Fresno. He'll talk about the fact that there are so many people out there in our community today that are being or have become aggressive toward police officers. That's why so many shootings, four in the last month or so. So Joe Gomez will be here to answer your questions if you call in. And by the way, the number is 436-ME-TV, option 11. All right, you're watching us right now on Comcast Channel 375, each and every Monday through Friday, live at 10 o'clock, of course. That's with Comcast, or a lot of people call it Xfinity 375. All right, the replay comes at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, 13.6, 4.6 Biz TV at 8 o'clock at night. That's prime time. The Twitter account, my friends, has not changed. It remains the same at John Mallos, Me TV. Okay, I mentioned to you that this is movie day. Becky Cinema is not here, but we're going to talk about the movies anyway. One movie in particular, it's called Aram Aram. Now, this is about a 12-year-old Armenian boy who lives in the city of Beirut, Lebanon. That's like a half a world away, right, from us. However, his parents get involved in a car accident. They both die, and suddenly, this 12-year-old boy, Aram, is left without his parents. And so what happens? he has to move to Los Angeles, of all places. That's right, Los Angeles, to live with his grandfather. And so, in my opinion, I mean, you may as well pick that boy up and moved him and placed him on the moon or Mars. Anyway, what a talk about a change and culture shock. And Aram is having a difficult time adjusting to his new life in Los Angeles because he is, I think, encouraged or maybe influenced by all the bad things that we hear about in Los Angeles. That's drugs, cars, money, maybe prostitution, maybe all of the above. He's living in Little Armenia there in Los Angeles. The movie sold out at the LA Film Festival. It opens here on the red carpet in Fresno today. It'll open in Los Angeles on October the 16th, and then it will make the tour around the country. The lead cast, by the way, is all Armenian. The writer and the director is not Armenian. He doesn't have a drop of Armenian blood in him, but he wrote and produced this wonderful film that you have to see. Christopher Chambers in his first full-length film. I want you to take a look at a clip right now.
He's my grandson. Yeah, don't touch this, Senor Angelet.
I am Aram.
Aram, I promised your parents I will take care of you.
But Nile, կորցրել էր միակ աղջկան, ոնց որ դու կորցրել ես մորդ, նա քեզ շատ է սիրում.
Ես էլ մեր արեստանոց.
Արամ, ասի քուխանութիդ.
Գրաֆիտին, սրանց համար սկիզբն է, դե դու գիտես. Ես քո ապահովության մասին եմ մտածում.
I can give you protection.
Ես կմտածեմ ձեր առաջարկի մասին. Շնորհակալություն.
I'm sure you got nothing to worry about.
Aram.
Get in. Do you like quality, Aram? You want Mercedes or you want junk?
I want Mercedes.
I know it.
Oh.
Because you're just like me, man.
You want to roll with me? You have to do exactly as I say.
Ոնց է ժամանակ անցկացնում, ինչ է կանում այդ նոր ընկերներից հետ։
Չէ, ես իրեն համար կաշխատում։
Այդ ամբանը գիտի աշխատել ինչ բանը։
Ինքը հարգան
կուրք։
You want respect, don't take shit from nobody.
Որ ես պետք է հերթամ։
Արամ, Արամ! What's happening to you? He's changing you. Do not contact him. Do not speak to him. I beg you, he's all that I have.
Её надо иметь, чтобы она не поимела тебя, надо успеть, но тот, кто по жизни задаёт фальшивый тон плагиата, будет.
Live in our studio now is Christopher Chambers, the writer and the director of Aram Aram. It is a wonderful film. I've seen the clips, read the reviews. In fact, he's here to take your phone calls. 436-ME-TV, option 11. We'll tell you where you can see it tonight on the red carpet. And by the way, I just want to say this about the film. The Hollywood Reporter wrote the following about Aram Aram. In the reporter, it said, the first-time writer-director Christopher Chambers has crafted a potent, loving, detailed evocation of an unfamiliar California subculture. The film deserves to be seen. Aram Aram, debuting tonight and then around the country later on. 436-ME-TV, option 11. It's a film that anyone can see. Yes, the cast is Armenian, but it appeals to the mass audiences out there across the country. Back in just a moment.
When you're looking for KitchenAid innovation and quality, who has the answers, the selection, the price? Ventura TV Appliance. With billions in nationwide appliance buying power, more than Home Depot and Best Buy combined, we'll help you save. Our low prices on ENERGY STAR qualified KitchenAid appliances save you energy and money, and pay no interest on select models when paid in full within 12 months. Ventura TV Appliance, serving you since 1951.
The following is a list of celebrities you will not see on MeTV programs. Charlie Sheen, Lindsay Lohan, Snooki, Paris Hilton, Perez Hilton, Honey Boo Boo, Justin Bieber, Simon Cowell, Chris Brown, Miley Cyrus, and the Real Housewives of any place. This is who you will see on MeTV programs. Lucy, Ralph, Mary, Perry, Gilligan, Kenneth, Spock, Batman, Rowdy, Festus, and the Beaver. MeTV. Thanks for watching.
Have you or a loved one recently been arrested for a serious crime?
Is your professional reputation at risk?
Aggressive representation from a qualified defense attorney can help you avoid conviction and keep your reputation untarnished.
Hi, I'm Charles McGill, and I'll fight for your rights. With extensive experience in successfully defending against a wide range of criminal offenses and high-profile cases, you can rest assured that you'll get the fair trial you deserve from McGill Guzman McGill. Call us at 559-255-3425 or visit us online at toplawyersfresno.com.
Want to create something extraordinary? Create perfection. Our lifestyle appliances make it easy. KitchenAid, Ventura TV Appliance, and you. When only the best will do.
Back here on the program talking about Arm Arm. It is a film that's coming out today here in Fresno and then October the 16th in Los Angeles, and what rave reviews it got at the LA Film Festival and also other film festivals around, and our guest will talk about that today. But if you check this out, I printed this out online. I got it offline, of course. And it's Rick Bentley's column, Fresno Bee. He reviewed this film, Arm Arm, and he basically, I don't know, just from what I read from this article, I'm getting the impression Rick Bentley likes it. He apparently gave it the thumbs up. Am I right, Christopher?
We almost got 4 stars. It was an incredible, incredible
review. Good to see you, my friend.
Review. Yeah, thank you. It's good to be here.
Yeah, go ahead. Talk about the review.
The review came out last night, and I have heard that Rick Bentley, you don't know if he's going to like a film or not. If he doesn't, he will pan it in his column. And it came through last night, and we were floored at it. He loved the film.
Yeah. True story or not?
This story is actually based on research and imagination. It's not a true story. But I can tell you this, when we were researching the film and we were looking for a location to shoot in, I went into a location, I told an Armenian man about the story, and he went white.
Where was this?
This was in Little Armenia in Los Angeles.
Okay.
So the story...
So you told him your idea about a film?
Exactly. I told him the story we were looking to shoot.
Okay.
And we were looking for a location. And this man went white and his eyes bugged out. And I said, it's a story about an Armenian boy who comes to America and he falls in with the wrong crowd. And it's his relationship with his grandfather who has a shoe repair store. And it's all set in Little Armenia. And it's about a child who falls in with the wrong crowd. And he was stunned. I said, are you okay? He said, you're telling me my life story back to me. And the hair went up on the back of my neck and I realized we're on the right path here. We're telling a story that even though it's fiction, it's true. It happens every day.
Wow. And when did you start filming?
So we started filming 2 years ago, August 24th.
So this happened 2 years ago when
Yes.
you met this man.
And
Yes. so have you kept in contact with him? Has he seen the film?
Yes, well he said to me, he said, I will help you however I can. And we ended up shooting almost half the film in his shoe repair store in Los Angeles. And I got him 2 tickets to our world premiere at the Los Angeles Film Festival. And I wasn't sure what he'd think about it because it must be emotional to see this story. And he came up to me afterwards and gave me a big hug and he said, thank you for getting this story out there.
He enjoyed it. He liked it.
He loved it. He had tears in his eyes.
Yeah. Well, it's, you know, he's looking at him at his own life up on the big screen. So I'm sure very emotional for him. But I got to ask you something. So you said this story is not true. You know, it's imagination and everything. How did you imagine in your wildest dreams to come up with a story like this? I mean, having not been around Armenians, I'm assuming, not that much, right? Not knowing the Armenian culture that well, I'm assuming. How did some light go off in your head or what?
Yeah, well, I think what happened was when I was about 20 years old, I made my first Armenian friend. And he started telling me about the culture, that it was the first Christian nation. He told me about the Armenian genocide. And something hooked into me that I can't explain. Next thing you know, at 3 a.m, I was on the internet researching Armenian immigration.
Yeah, but I'll bet the first thought that crossed your mind, I could be wrong, was the first thought maybe making a film about the genocide?
Oh, well, no, you know what? I think I love to see
just
dramas.
A question.
Yeah.
It wasn't your first thought?
That wasn't my first thought, actually.
Every Armenian film you see, it's about the genocide. But this one is not.
That's true. This is a modern story.
Isn't that great? I love that.
Audiences seem to really respond to it because it's a story about life today.
Yeah. Yeah, we all know about the genocide and how horrible it is and how awful it is that this country doesn't yet, to this day, 100 years later, does not recognize the Armenian genocide. I think it's awful, but it's politics, I guess, you know. But back to the film, and we have a caller. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Good morning. Christopher, I heard there's another movie, I believe it's called Black Mass with Johnny Depp. Have you seen that one? What do you think about it? I hear great reviews about it, probably one of the best movies he's ever been, but I hope you've seen it. So what do you think about this movie?
Sure.
I haven't seen it yet.
You know what? It's on my radar, but we've been so busy at film festivals, going to the Montreal Film Festival. We were in a festival in Armenia that we haven't had a chance to really sit down and watch a movie in quite a long time.
Yeah.
But you know, it's been really exciting to see our poster for Aram Aram in the lobby next to Johnny Depp's Black Mass. So it's really exciting for us that we're actually going to be coming out to theater starting tonight at Maya Cinemas and having a chance to be in the same theaters that these big movies that we all know and love are playing in. It's very exciting to be here.
Thank you, caller. I appreciate it. So you just called it Aram Aram. I called it Aram Aram. Which is correct? Are they both correct?
Well, I mean, technically it'd be Aram.
Aram.
Yes, because this is a very common Armenian name, like John or Bob.
Yeah.
So the accent would be different. Yeah, exactly.
So Aram Aram.
Yes.
All right. Now you mentioned just a minute ago you did a little bit of research because you met this friend who was Armenian. He told you about the Armenian culture a little bit and you did research. But how much did you really research at that point? How much did you know?
I would say I knew nothing. I would say I knew the opposite of I knew only the stereotypes I had heard and only what was happening in the media. And
which was what?
At the time, there was a lot in the media about Armenian gangs, which have since been really cracked down on and really broken.
In L.A.
In L.A., okay. Of course.
Get a lot of publicity in L.A.?
They did at the time when I began researching this. But it really doesn't represent the Armenian culture at all.
No.
There's such a diverse culture. There's many different ethnicities, many different classes. Very educated, very cultured group of people. Really cultured. And when I realized that, that's why we designed this character like the grandfather, who's played by Levon Sharafian. He's a very cultured character. He has a classical training in piano in the film. He's a former, and what you'll find in Los Angeles anyway, these shoe repair stores, they're all owned by Armenian men who are immigrants, and all of them had another dream. All of them are very cultured, well-read. They were either classically trained actors, classically trained musicians, pianists. They all had another dream, but then when they came to America, they had to provide for their families.
It's funny you mention a shoeshine shop because in 1897 or 1898, my grandfather was put on a boat at the age of 9, somehow ended up in Oakland, California, after he landed on the East Coast, of course. Then he ended up in Oakland at his uncle's shoeshine shop.
Wow.
Amazing. I mean, there are 1.5 million. I mean, there are probably 10 million stories like that of immigrants that come to this country that end up in the same place.
Yeah, I mean, that's what's amazing, what I realized. And what we tried to tell at the core was a story about a child that's fundamental and universal to the American experience. This story is not representing specifically Armenians, but it's representing an American experience that's happened since the first waves of immigration. My grandfather went through the same struggles himself when he came from Switzerland.
But it happens with every culture.
Exactly, exactly.
You know, the Irish, the German.
Italians.
The Italians, the Greeks, the Koreans.
We had a Korean girl crying at the end of our film. It's not actually a sad ending, it's just a very emotional climax. And I said to her, I said, why are you crying? I'm curious, I understand. If you're Armenian, why you really connect with this story, like a lot of our Armenian audiences have. She said, in my neighborhood in Koreatown, in Los Angeles, she said, this story happens every day. It just happens in Korean.
You're proud of the film, aren't you?
I'm proud of seeing people react emotionally to the hard work we put in and the hard work my actors put in.
It took, what, 2 years to film?
2 years from the first day of filming till we are releasing it to the public.
Wow, a lot of hard work. Christopher Chambers is the writer and the director of Adam Adam, and of course it debuts today. We'll tell you where, on the red carpet here in the city of Fresno, and then it goes to Los Angeles, and then it goes around the country. We're back here on the program. Connect with me in just a moment, 436-ME-TV, option 11.
Frigidaire. We introduced the first home freezer. The first pulsator agitator washer. And now we introduce the Frigidaire Orbit Clean Dishwasher, designed with a unique wash arm that gives you four times more water coverage for a consistently better clean. Frigidaire, over 90 years of legendary innovation. See,
have you or a loved one recently been arrested for a serious crime?
Is your professional reputation at risk?
Aggressive representation from a qualified defense attorney can help you avoid conviction and keep your reputation untarnished.
Hi, I'm Charles McGill, and I'll fight for your rights. With extensive experience in successfully defending against a wide range of criminal offenses and high-profile cases, you can rest assured that you'll get the fair trial you deserve from McGill Guzman McGill. Call us at 559-255-3425 or visit us online at toplawyersfresno.com.
Revan is now on KVHF channel 4.4.
Hello, I'm John Walsh. The Justice Network is seen here in Fresno and made possible by the Ventura Broadcasting Company. To see how law enforcement all across Central California are fighting crime, watch Local Choice with Austin Reed, where you'll see interviews and special reports with those who keep us safe every day. Local Choice with Austin Reed, daily on the Justice Network, Fresno, exclusively on KVBC channel 13.5.
I'm serious. Back here on the program with Christopher Chambers. He is the writer and the director of Adam Adam. You can catch it tonight. And there is Christopher, our guest, 436-ME-TV, option 11. Hey, caller, you've been patient. Go ahead. You're on the air.
Hi, good morning, John, and good morning, Christopher. Thank you very much for taking my call. First thing, really quick, I've got two quick questions and a comment. The quick questions would be, what's it rated, and would it be appropriate? I noticed that one of the characters is a child, but is this appropriate for, say, a 10 to 12-year-old child?
Good question.
Would be one, and then how long will it be in Fresno? Because it doesn't look like I'm going to be able to make it in the next day or two, so I'm hoping it'll be in the theaters for a little while. And my last comment is, I find it interesting that your character is a shoemaker from Lebanon, because that's what my father-in-law is, and I'm sure he had dreams, and I know a lot of other shoemakers and shoe owners that are from that area, and I'm looking forward to seeing this movie. The last year, Hawaii Five-O, the new Hawaii Five-O, and a couple other TV shows have painted the Armenians in the kind of a negative light, and this looks like it's going to be somewhat of a positive film, even though it's dealing with some heavy issues. So that's
okay.
My comments and my questions, and I'll take the answers over the air.
All right. So question one, as I recall, was what? Age appropriate.
Yes. That's a great question. It's basically, I'd say, a hard PG. So if you're right on the line, for in my opinion, about 12 years old, because there's a little bit of violence in it. It's not very violent, but it's basically, we tell people PG-13 to be conservative.
But it's got to have a little bit of violence in there, because you're dealing with, all the hardcore bad things that we hear about that go on in LA.
Exactly. And there's certain things that happen where we wouldn't want a young, say a 5 or 6 year old to watch it. But definitely in this era, say 12 years old and up, I would say it's definitely appropriate.
Yeah.
And in terms of how long it's going to be running, we're going to be running for a full week here at Maya Cinemas. Tonight is the red carpet premiere.
From Thursday to Thursday?
All the way till the 8th, whatever day that is.
Oh, so. Look at that. There's the graphic right there. Uh-huh. A film by Christopher Chambers, of course, opening August the 2nd. But tonight is what?
October
2nd. What did I say?
Yes.
August 2nd. Okay. You know, I'm a little behind the times here, Christopher. So it's opening October the 2nd. And where is the Maya Cinemas? And also, what time does it start tonight?
Sure. So tonight is actually our red carpet world premiere. Literally the first time ever we're going to show the film publicly. And tickets are available at Fandango.com and at the box office. They're selling pretty fast, but I think if you show up a little bit early, you can definitely come there. You can meet the stars, get your picture taken on the red carpet.
Wow.
Everybody's invited, and tickets are on sale. And Maya Cinemas has given us the best theater in the house.
Where is Maya Cinemas?
Maya Cinemas is right down the street from Fresno State, right near that center, the Save Mart Center. Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
Yes.
The basketball center.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So it's right around the corner, and it's
right by
it's
the arena there.
State of the art place. I mean, these guys have built an amazing theater.
Really?
And it's going to be huge. They're still opening it up. The shopping center's still opening up.
Fantastic. So it'll be playing there for a week. I have a week to see it, right?
Yes, exactly. It's
going to
play after tonight. Tonight's screening is at 8 p.m. It's the red carpet premiere. It's going to be off the charts. It's going to be a great night. And then starting tomorrow, October 2nd, it's going to be running every day, 4 or 5 times a day until the 8th. So there's definitely many chances to catch it if you're really busy tonight.
Do you have a tuxedo for tonight? I want to know. I mean, I see. You know, we're going to talk to one of the actors here in just a few minutes. He's going to be along as well.
Right, right.
But is everybody renting a tuxedo? You got to be black attire, right? Am I right? You're laughing, but it's true.
Well, though,
you
I'm only
hurry.
I'm
You're
only
running
laughing.
Out of time.
I don't think I've worn a tuxedo since prom, and that night didn't go that great. So
we see Nordstrom's, Macy's. I don't know where you can you get a tux this late? I don't know.
Do any of your callers have a tux that'll fit me? That's the question. Call in now if you have a tux that's my size.
Let me ask you something, though. You know, the caller also mentioned, like, Hawaii 5-0, the new Hawaii 5, not the old one.
Yes.
Why are they portraying Armenians in such a negative light in the media and in Hollywood, do you think?
Well, you
it's not the nature of their culture and they're, you know, they live all over the world. They come from Armenia. They're wonderful people. They're educated. They're smart. So what's the deal with Hollywood?
So this is actually kind of the starting point for this film, that for a lot of people that don't know Armenians, their point of access is the media. And the media doesn't even realize that they stereotype Armenians, even in the news, as sort of this gangster fraud culture, especially in Los Angeles. And that does not represent the culture at all. And that's kind of why I decided to make this kind of film, which is taking the starting point for a lot of Americans about this negative stereotype, which is not a true stereotype, and entering into that stereotype and then disassembling it, telling a story that's about family. And that, at the core, is what Aram Aram is really about. And that's actually what Armenian culture is about. If you get to meet any of them, there's an incredible warmth and devotion to family that I have not seen.
And culture.
And so powerful.
Yeah.
It's a very loving, very powerful, very strong culture.
Okay. Little Armenia. Located in Los Angeles,
yes.
But where in Los Angeles? Like, I know where the old Inglewood Forum is located. I know where Dodger Stadium is located. I know exactly where the Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum is. I know where USC is located. I know where O.J. Simpson's old house used to stand, okay? I don't know where Little Armenia is.
Well, I think by taking that tour just now, you drove through it.
Are you serious?
So Little Armenia, it's very complicated because there's many different communities in Los Angeles, many different waves.
Yeah.
But I can say Little Armenia proper is in Hollywood, near, say, between Hobart and Vermont, near on Santa Monica, basically in the heart of Hollywood. But literally...
Okay, so is it... Okay, I know where Santa Monica is. That's
right,
my
Santa
old
Monica
hangout.
Boulevard. Yeah,
Santa Monica Boulevard in Santa Monica. So how close is it to, say, UCLA or
nowhere
Westwood?
Near there. It's really on the other side of town in Hollywood. It's on the east side of Hollywood, East Hollywood, you could say.
Is it kind of in an area that's questionable?
It's an area where there have been later waves of immigration that kind of brought the neighborhood down, but it's on its way back up. They're doing a lot to redevelop it. But
and
the
how
real
big an area
yeah.
is it?
It's not very big. I'd say it's about north and south. It's in north and south. It's maybe about 10 blocks. East and west, it's about a mile. But the real heart for our film and for a huge part of the Armenian population is in Glendale. And that to us is actually what we think of as Little Armenia, because we shot most of a lot of the film there, and almost all of our actors live there. So and we're going to open the film there.
Quickly, before I go to break, the LA Film Festival, rave reviews. Talk about that just before we go to break.
That was the most emotional experience of this entire journey. We had no idea we would sell out. We had no idea we would get an amazing review from The Hollywood Reporter. It's
Hang
been
on,
really
caller.
Amazing.
Go ahead.
It was just an amazing experience to have the lights go down in the theater and 400 people sit in silence and listen to your film and really respond. The LA Film Festival was an incredible experience.
Was it more satisfying to make the film and have it be successful? Well, we don't know if it's going to be successful at the box office yet.
True.
That's kind of, but successful in your eyes so far in making it, or is it more rewarding to see the reaction from people who've actually seen the film? Which satisfies you the most?
Yeah. To me, there's nothing better than being a part of the legacy of a storyteller. Since we were first gathering around fires, we're telling stories and engaging our imaginations and our emotions, and that's what we're trying to do with this movie.
But what about the patron in the first row that says, "Wow, what a film!" Doesn't that
That's what it's all about.
Doesn't that give you goosebumps?
It does. My eyes teared up the first time we showed this in front of a full movie house. And I heard people, you can hear when people are reacting to the film. There's certain points of the film where the whole audience will react or they won't. And they did. And to me, that's what it's all about, being part of that, giving people an emotional experience. Because that's what I want from a movie.
Yeah. Caller, go ahead. You're on the air.
Good morning. Morning, John. Good morning, Christopher.
Good morning.
You know, the purpose of this movie, could you give me, I'm going to do a little dialogue with you. The purpose of the movie was, or is, and you fill in the blanks, and does this show a happy ending, without telling me the movie, and I won't see
don't
it.
Don't tell me the ending, please.
Does this hopefully show a happy ending? You can say yes or no.
I definitely will not spoil the ending for anybody, because I would be angry if someone did that to me. The
go
point.
Ahead. Turn, wait a second. Go ahead.
Yeah. You know what I was waiting for, and I know. I know it may not happen. You know, I'm dreaming on. Is something that Dead Hires and the priests and the Butt-Bellies from Burbank, Glendale, North Hollywood, and Pasadena work with the Russian Armenians and tell them about Christ Jesus. Now, that would make a good movie where they would talk to them, get involved, you know, show some action, of course. And I know they lost their first love for God, a lot of them. Not a whole lot, you know, there's a lot of them out there just sleeping Sundays. But the purpose, that would be a great movie. I can't say a lot of people would come to it, but it would be one of the movies that are out on the theaters today, Christian movies. That would be a good movie, and showing that the Armenians need to get back to the Lord. And that's one, that would be a great movie, and showing how they do it and what it takes for them to do it, because a lot of them are just lost. They're just lost mentally and physically, and I'm sorry to say. Okay, thank you, Christopher, for listening.
So I can tell you this.
Thank you very much. What about those Russian Armenians who, in his opinion, have lost their way?
Well, I'll have to tell you, quite honestly, two things. One is there's an actual parable from the Bible that is the thematic underpinning of this entire film. I'm not going to give away which one it is, but that was the foundation upon which we wrote this film. So when you see the film and you see the ending, let me know if you figure out what it is. And in terms of Armenians in Los Angeles, I have to say I have never met people that have a stronger faith. Everyone I met is very, very strongly and proudly Christian. So there may be people like you're talking about. In my personal experience, which of course is just my personal experience, I have seen a very, very strong connection to their Christian origins and great pride in being the first Christian nation in the history of humanity.
All right, more talk here with Christopher Chambers, the writer and the director of a film that debuts today at the Maya Cinemas here in the city of Fresno. We're by Fresno State. And what time does that start? I forgot.
Very exciting. So the red carpet starts at 7 p.m. The screening starts at 8 p.m. at Maya Cinemas tonight.
Wonderful. 436 MeTV, option 11. The film is called Autumn. Back here with our guest in just a moment.
When you like Ventura TV Appliance on Facebook, it's nice. But when you love the Frigidaire Gallery appliances we deliver, it's even better. Our website is cool, and it's a good place to start, but you really should touch the merchandise before you buy.
Time for that upgrade to an Energy Star qualified French door Frigidaire Gallery refrigerator. Quality appliances for the way you live. Get the best selection, price, and service in town without waiting. Come in to Ventura TV Appliance and touch the merchandise.
Sports is now on KBHF 4.3.
Hello, I'm John Walsh. The Justice Network is seen here in Fresno and made possible by the Ventura Broadcasting Company. To see how law enforcement all across Central California are fighting crime, watch Local Choice with Austin Reed, where you'll see interviews and special reports with those who keep us safe every day. Local Choice with Austin Reed, daily on the Justice Network, Fresno, exclusively on KVBC Channel 13.5.
How's it going, little G?
Okay.
Ese paput mo tametin. Eti chadzar.
Handose.
Let me see. Get in. Es otar utelik esirmes, ha?
Şem gider.
This is not quality. Do you like quality, Aram?
Oh, yeah.
You want Mercedes or you want junk?
I want Mercedes.
I know it. You know how I know it?
Oh.
Because you're just like me, man. Don't eat this with that crap. Արդեն քանի տարի է ես սրանով եմ ապրում ու ռեփն այն տեղը որ սնում է իմ ուղեղը ու ես ստեղ եմ դեռ շատ շուտ բանից ու էլի հայք էլի ռեփ նորից ու նորից
Գիտեմ ինչպես քշեմ
Հա որտեղ ես սովորը
Բեյրութ
Չէ եթե Բեյրութում քշել ես ուրեմն լավ քշել ես
Օքեյ
Ավելի հեշտ դուներ եթե դաշից վերև կարան դեր
Նոմ դես
հա You want to drive a Mercedes?
Այո
Maybe one day I'll let you.
On freeway.
Little G. I like that.
That's a clip of Autumn. Autumn debuts tonight, 7 o'clock, and then 8 o'clock is the feature film at the Maya Cinemas. It's over at Shaw and 168. Christopher Chambers is here, the writer, the director of the film, of course. And Christopher, I want to go through some of these pictures. We have three of them. Let's put picture number one up on the screen so you can catch that. And that's the poster. And we have that up here on our store here at Ventura TV. And how'd you come up with that design?
Well, so I was working with
Who's that on the front cover, by the way?
That is John Rohinian, our very talented 12-year-old star. And if you want to know what's difficult, try anchoring an entire feature film as a 12-year-old. It's really a remarkable performance. Yeah.
And photo number two, there it is. Who are these people?
That's cast members? Yeah, this is at our LA Film Festival premiere.
Start from left to right, if you
Sure. Know. From left is Seva Kakoyan, who's one of our lead characters. There's Levon Sharafian in the older gentleman. He's a very famous Armenian actor, extremely accomplished. Next, David Viada, who's a great up-and-coming actor in Hollywood. And John Rohinian next to me, our young star.
Yeah, okay. Now, talk about, let's go to photo number three real quick. Okay, and this is, that is Levon right there, right?
Yes, that's the two of us speaking about a scene. This is on the final night of filming with Levon Sharafian, his final scene. And he's a truly great actor. He has the equivalent of the Academy Award, Lifetime Achievement Award, from Armenia. He's been in 500 television episodes, every Shakespearean tragedy on stage, and this is his first American film ever.
And yeah, I was just reading a little bit of history about how you got him to play one of the lead roles and characters in this film. How did you get him? This guy's like a star in Armenia. He's like Laurence Olivier of Armenia.
Exactly, exactly. So basically, I had seen him in TV shows. I said, this guy has this weight to him. He has there's a depth to him that this character needs to have. But I couldn't figure out how to find him. And so I became obsessed, and I put his picture as the wallpaper on my laptop. And every morning when I'd wake up, I would see his face. And every night when I went to bed, he would be there looking at me, saying, come on, find me, find me. And I couldn't find him. We finally
go to People Finders.
People Finders.
People Finders on the internet. I don't know.
And so after a month of casting, we still hadn't seen somebody to play the role. And we pushed the whole production back a month. I said, this role's too important. One day, this guy comes in. I recognized him from a scene he'd been in. He'd been in the background. And I said to him, I said, do you mind if I ask you a question? That audition was very nice. Do you know this man? He looked at my laptop. He's like, LaVon, of course I know him. I go, do you know where he is? Is he in Armenia? Is he in America? He goes, he lives right next door in Glendale. I said, do you know how to contact him? He goes, I call him on my cell phone. He calls him on the cell phone. He says, you want to meet him today? I go, today? He said, yeah. He said, what time? I said, how about 2:30? 2:30, he showed up. I told him the story. No audition. I said, would you like to do the film? He said, why not?
Wow, and he has starred in more than 30 films and 500 episodes on television, and I'm assuming this is in Armenia?
Exactly. Well, they shoot the Armenian series both in Armenia and in Los Angeles.
Okay.
So he's worked both. He's lived in America for about 20 years, but...
But shuffles back and forth.
Exactly. And Russia as well. He's performed all over the world on stage.
Is he a Russian-Armenian?
So he's Armenian and Armenian, but he also was alive during the Soviet era.
Gotcha. So okay. All right. You know, I do want to bring your other the other guest in here. He's one of your stars in the film.
Yes.
And he's the bad guy, though.
He's the bad guy.
I got to say, he's the bad guy. But we're going to bring him up here and talk to him about that. He's laughing over there. Did he mind being the bad guy?
You'll have to ask him. I think that I know he went into this role with all his heart, and he made a real human out of this character.
Because
if you don't, it's not deep enough, you know?
I'm just making humor out of this a little bit, trying to lighten it up. Anyway, okay, we're going to be back with our second guest here, talking about the film Autumn, Autumn. And listen, Christopher, congratulations.
Thank you so much for having us.
You deserve all the success and accolades, my friend. I can't wait to see the film. It opens up tonight. I got a week to see it in Fresno.
That's right. Thank you for your support. We really appreciate it.
Thank you. Christopher Chambers, the writer-director of Autumn, Autumn, begins tonight, the red carpet, over at the Maya Cinemas, and that's at Shaw and 168. 7 o'clock, be there. You can, you know, take your pictures with the stars. We're back with our show in just a moment.
Have you or a loved one recently been arrested for a serious crime?
Is your professional reputation at risk?
Aggressive representation from a qualified defense attorney can help you avoid conviction and keep your reputation untarnished.
Hi, I'm Charles McGill, and I'll fight for your rights. With extensive experience in successfully defending against a wide range of criminal offenses and high-profile cases, you can rest assured that you'll get the fair trial you deserve from McGill Guzman McGill. Call us at 559-255-3425 or visit us online at toplawyersfresno.com.
Want to create something extraordinary? Create perfection. Our lifestyle appliances make it easy. KitchenAid, Ventura TV Appliance, and you, when only the best will do.
Take a look at this.
Let's play.
This is too hip for you. I'll slow down.
Let's play.
Watch all your favorite classic game shows on Buzzer TV, KBBC Digital Channel 13.7.
And back here on the program today on a Thursday morning, talking about this film, Autumn, Autumn, which, you know, the red carpet is going to be rolled out tonight. It debuts at the Maya Cinemas in Fresno, Shaw and 68. And Autumn, Autumn is about a 12-year-old boy living in Beirut, Lebanon. His parents are killed in a car crash. has to move to Los Angeles, of all places, in Little Armenia to live with his grandfather. Suddenly, the 12-year-old boy, Adam, and there he is right there, starring in the film, John Ruhinian plays the 12-year-old, and he gets caught up in all the bad things that we hear about in Los Angeles, like the drugs, the cars, the women, the money, right? The money and the women, right? They all go hand in hand, right? So anyway, the guy who has the major influence on little Adam, 12 years old, is played by Sevak Hakoyan. He joins me now. Sevak, congratulations on the film.
Thank you for being here.
And I'm sorry, I didn't mean to insult you, but you play the bad guy in the film. How do you feel about that?
It's not an insult, because they are a human being too.
Yeah.
They just ended up like that.
Yeah, yeah. Tell us your role in the film. What is your role in the film, and how did you digest it all, and how do you play a role like that?
Yeah.
Go ahead and tell us what your role was.
Yeah, Hako plays the gangster character.
Yeah.
I would say he's the guy who, in his life, made decisions that led him to the life he's living.
Okay.
And
what kind of life is that? Just with drugs, alcohol?
Drugs, alcohol. It's like where he's trying to take Adam. And he didn't have the people next to him to direct him into the right right path. So he's the guy that ended up making the wrong decisions and pursuing the pride, the power, the money, and trying to get the respect from his elderlies.
Yeah.
So yeah.
How did he, and your role in the film was mm-hmm. to try to influence and suck in Adam, right? And how mm-hmm. How were you able to do that? When you looked at the script, did you say to yourself, hey, I can do that? I can do that part.
When I looked at the role and I read the script, it was seeing a human being, you know? When I was working on bringing this character to life, I wanted to make it as truthful and as honest as possible, nothing stereotypical. And it was easy, you know? The first day we met with the kid, John, we hit it off. We were like 10 minutes in, we were already outside playing with his skateboard, with his little brother, and just having fun. And there was that connection. So the collaboration was there. Like, we connected real good. We were having so much fun. And it was, in my mind, you know, off screen, it was me trying to have as much fun as I can with a kid who's going to probably pick up on this energy and try to be, you know, like, similar to maybe have more fun, like, equal my level. So it was off screen and on screen. I was trying to kind of like have him work with me.
Yeah. Now, you are full-blooded Armenian.
Yes.
Is that correct? Now, where do you come from? Where does your family come from?
We're all from Yerevan.
Okay.
Yerevan, Armenia, which is the capital.
How long have you been here?
12 years.
12 years. And
yes.
Currently you live in Los Angeles?
Yes.
Okay. Now, this film, of course, we talked about Adam and his parents die and he's got to move to Los Angeles and he gets caught up in all this stuff. Is it, and I have to ask you this, is it a, in your mind, you looked at the script and you played the role,
mm-hmm.
is it a negative portrayal of Armenians or is it positive? Or is it just a reality check?
I would have to go with the third one. Basically, as an artist, when I read the script, I saw the struggles that this person went through. And there is a reality to that. There's a lot of people that I see personally that are dressed up like, you know, my character, that are making wrong decisions. So for me, it was trying to
because they're not getting the right direction?
The right direction. It's the peer pressure. It's just the life of LA. And I just wanted to build a human being that was going to be genuine and honest and just living a life that, you know, brought him there, like the decisions that actually brought him to that point in his life.
Yeah.
And I don't see it as a negative portrayal. The big picture for me was, it's a story of coming together. It's a story of family. It's a story of this boy, you know, going through this wrong path and then, you know, eventually whatever happens in the film. And it's a universal story that speaks to everybody.
Yeah.
So hopefully the film, when people watch, when kids watch, will influence to make right decisions in their lives.
I'm asking you this because you're Armenian. You're mm-hmm. full-blooded Armenian from Armenia, mm-hmm. no less. And yeah. and you could probably answer this question best. What's the biggest misnomer about Armenians?
Misnomer?
Yeah.
Like
what's the biggest what's the biggest misconception about or portrayal of Armenians? I mean, what's the perception or misperception?
Misperception. I have a lot of American friends, and we're the angry guys, we're the stereotypical, the fraud, the, you know, all these negative connotations that come because they see, especially when you go to Glendale, you see all the BMWs, all the Mercedes Benzes. So that all they're the rich guys with all the jewelry, you know, like over exaggerated. That's the kind of vibe that I've gotten from my friends. But
wow.
then associating with me, they know that it's not such.
Yeah, it's not true.
Yeah,
hey,
it's
by
not
the
true.
Way, that last film clip, I got to go to break, but that last film clip that we played with the driver in the Mercedes trying to lure Aram, and he lured him in the car, was that you?
Yes.
That was you?
That was me. Yeah.
You want a Mercedes or do you want junk? Huh? Come on, Aram, tell me. Do you want junk or do you want a Mercedes?
Yeah, see, that's the funny thing. I mean, off screen, like right after the film, whenever we watch it,
yeah,
most
take
people
it
don't
screen.
Recognize.
Here it is right here. Okay. All right, now you're in the film. We're not gonna play the sound on this.
Sure.
But that's you?
That is me. Yes, that is me. That's the transformation I had to go through. I originally looked like this exactly when I went to Chris's place. And that's the thing, see, like with Chris, after we went through putting all these external things that my character would, you know, have, like shaved, short cut hair, the goatee,
yeah.
the clothing, everything
the
that
hoodie.
Was external, yes, actually influenced my character too. That was a big part of creating my character.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, when I first saw that clip, I just didn't put two and two together that it could be you. I just didn't. I don't know why. And it just, for some reason, it dawned on me. Wait a minute. Maybe that's you.
That's good. Yeah, that's good.
No. Is that, there you are. Look, take it full screen. Take it full screen. Is that, oh, wow, that's you in the mirror right there.
That's me in the mirror.
What's up with the boxing gloves they're hanging? Is that like a thing it's, they do in Little Armenia there or what?
Yeah, it's just a, you know, Armenian flag on those boxing gloves, and a lot of cars have them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, we got to take a break here. We're talking with one of the actors in the movie Autumn, Sevak
Hakoyan.
Hakoyan. Okay, I got the name correctly. Hey, 436, MeTV, option 11. Question of the day. You want a Mercedes or do you want junk? Back in just a moment, my friends.
Hello, I'm John Walsh. The Justice Network is seen here in Fresno and made possible by the Ventura Broadcasting Company. To see how law enforcement all across Central California are fighting crime, watch Local Choice with Austin Reed,
hey,
where you'll see interviews and special reports with those who keep us safe every day. Local Choice with Austin Reed, daily on the Justice Network, Fresno, exclusively on KVBC Channel 13.5.
After God created the world, he made man and woman. Then, to keep the whole thing from collapsing, he invented humor.
Sub, a perfect reason to rejoice. A distinctly positioned channel in the crowded Hindi general entertainment channel space. It is India's only family comedy entertainment channel with a core brand promise of Asli Maza Sabke Saath Aata Hai.
Ah, dekh raha hu.
Which means celebrate the joy of being together. Taking humor as a universal language, the shows on Sub are light-hearted and make up for an enjoyable family viewing experience. Indeed.
Asli maza.
Sabke saath aata hai.
Ab to sabko pata hai yaar.
Sub TV is now on digital channel 31.8.
Have you or a loved one recently been arrested for a serious crime?
Is your professional reputation at risk?
Aggressive representation from a qualified defense attorney can help you avoid conviction and keep your reputation untarnished.
Hi, I'm Charles McGill, and I'll fight for your rights.
With extensive experience in successfully defending against a wide range of criminal offenses and high-profile cases, you can rest assured that you'll get the fair trial you deserve from Miguel Guzman McGill. Call us at 559-255-3425 or visit us online at toplawyersfresno.com.
I don't know why I have failed to mention on this program, I hope Chuck is not upset, but our program today is sponsored by Chuck McGill, the longtime defense attorney here in the city of Fresno, better than 25 years in business. Of course, sadly, his wife, Laura Guzman McGill, passed away just a couple of years ago from breast cancer, and that's why I'm wearing this. It is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, so go in and get checked, do the buddy check thing. It's all, the entire month of October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. And today being October the 1st, my gosh, where did the year go, Sevak? It's gone already almost.
Where is he going? Where are we going?
I don't know. How old are you, by the way?
I'm 27.
You're 27.
Yes.
You're young. My gosh. Okay, so this role here that you played the bad guy, gotta say. I have to tell it like it is. So will this help you get other roles in Hollywood?
It has certainly helped me recently to get a manager, and she sent me out to a few auditions already. So I see light.
At the end of the tunnel.
Yes.
You do.
Yes.
So you have a manager now?
Yes.
You do. Okay, how does it work in Hollywood? Do you have to have a manager and an agent?
Yeah, you could have both. Or you could have just a manager, or you could have just an agent.
So what's your manager supposed to do?
Manager helps you build your career, your image, put you on the right path, the schools you should go to, the education you should have, the headshots.
Does he get you the roles?
They can get you the roles too. They could send you to auditions also. Most managers have connections with casting directors, and most managers are able to send you to auditions. Yeah. Agent's job is only to like send you to an audition, get you through the door. Managers help you manage your career.
Is it tough? Is it a tough road to hoe?
It is a tough road to hoe, but after the film, oh, by the way, this was my very first film, just so that you know, it was my very first audition too.
Yeah, we got about 3 minutes here, and I do go to the Fresno Beat article, yeah. Written by Rick Bentley. You got to pull it up online or have it, you know, hard copy at home or something. But Bentley apparently likes the film from what I've read, and he says, and I quote in Bentley's column, here in the review, it says, Chambers' film, Christopher Chambers, his film has a distinct Armenian edge to it, but the story has a universal feel. The entire cast is 100% Armenian. The director, the writer, of course, is not.
Mm-hmm.
Does it have a universal appeal, in your opinion?
Definitely does, because especially the LA Film Festival, we had a full-packed 400-person audience, and not all of them were Armenian, but they all responded the same way. And we've been with the film to Montreal, I haven't been to Armenia, the Golden Apricot, and everybody responds the same way. At the end, everybody comes out from the theater with tears in their eyes, and we've had people from Spain even come up to us and be like, this story is amazing, it's beautiful, it's universal, we think kids should watch. So, yeah.
Yeah, because getting sucked into that lifestyle, you don't have to be Armenian. You could be Hmong, Chinese, Greek, any ethnic group. Every ethnic group is sucked in to a certain extent. You have these problems everywhere.
Yes.
You know, so, okay, mention the other cast members. We got John Ruhinian here. He plays the 12-year-old.
Uh-huh.
And then Levon.
Levon Sharafian.
Sharafian. He
yes.
is obviously.
He's the grandfather.
Yeah, he's the grandfather from Los Angeles. How is he to work with? He's in the center there, of course.
Yes. So here's this guy. It was amazing. It was amazing because I've grown up watching him on screen. And when I got casted, I didn't know that he plays the role of grandfather.
Yeah, there he
so
is.
So there he is, you know, and playing with a great character, seeing him prepare, and just being there, you know, it was amazing. I learned a lot.
Yeah, and then Ala Toumanian?
Ala Toumanian.
Toumanian.
Yes. She's another great actress.
Tell me about his role quickly here, running out of time.
Her role, I haven't played with her, but he is the grandfather's next door business, you know.
From Armenia as well?
Yes.
Okay.
She's from Armenia as well.
All right. And then you told your story. So the four main characters in this film, are they all, they're all from Armenia then, huh? Or
except
what about
John Ruhinian? John
Ruhinian. He was born and raised where?
He was born here. He was born and raised here. His mother is from Lebanon. His father is from Iran.
Yeah. Yeah, mm-hmm. It's amazing. So we got about 30 seconds left. It will debut tonight, Fresno, the Maya Cinemas, of course, Shaw and 168. And good luck. I hope
you have
a tuxedo.
I will be wearing the
black.
Same one, probably. Yeah, black.
Okay,
with a tie.
Black. Yeah, that's
if I
good.
Find a tie.
Seva, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, I can't wait to see the film myself. I'm going to go see it.
Yes.
So maybe not tonight. Maybe tonight I can't, but I will see it. I have a week.
Yep, seven days.
You got it. All right. That's going to do it for us tonight. I appreciate your time. Thanks for coming in. We're going to see you back here tomorrow. Our guest will be Joe Gomez, the lieutenant from the Fresno Police Department, talking about all the rash and recent police-involved shootings. See you tomorrow. Have a great day. Very good. Good, Selak. Thank you.